Many services like Google, Microsoft, or Apple are asking us to switch to something called passkeys. But what exactly are they? How do they work? And are they really more secure than the old way of logging in? In this video, I will explain why passwords are becoming a thing of the past and why passkeys are likely the next big thing in keeping our accounts safe. Make sure to watch until the end because I'm going to give you a simple demo of how you can test passkeys yourself, plus a sneak peek at how our passwordless future will work. Now, to understand passkeys, you need to know two things: how old school passwords work and how public key cryptography works. Now, let's start with the first one. You probably know the drill. Every time you sign up somewhere, you have to provide a username or your email and a password. This gets stored in a database. Now, passwords shouldn't be stored in plain text, they should be hashed, but that's a whole topic for another video. When you try to log in, you provide your username and password, and the server checks if they match anything in the database. If yes, you're in. This system has been around for a long time, but it does have flaws. Let's be real. Back in the day, we all used the same terrible password for everything, from our email to our MySpace account. Yeah, remember MySpace? Now, the problem is that if one service gets hacked and your password is exposed, hackers could try out the same credentials on other sites. Check how often your account has been hacked by going to a website like Have I Been Pwned? Over time, websites required more complex passwords, longer, with numbers, symbols, capital letters, you know, the kind of password you definitely won't remember. So some of us started using password managers like LastPass, 1Password, KeePass, or, you know, sticky notes on the monitor. Not recommended. Still, that wasn't enough. Hackers kept getting through, so companies added another step to secure our accounts. This is where two-factor authentication, 2FA, or multi-factor authentication, MFA, comes in. You'll probably use it before. Maybe you'll get a text, an email, or a code from an app like Google Authenticator. You might even get a prompt on a device you're already logged into. But honestly, how many times have you waited for that one text that never showed up? This method added another layer of security. The idea was simple. Even if someone figures out your password, it's unlikely they will also have access to your second device. But it is kind of a hassle, and let's face it, most people didn't bother setting it up anyway. So all these big companies had enough. Enter passkeys. Passkeys ditched the idea of something you know, like a password, for something you have, like a device, secured with your fingerprint, face, PIN, or a pattern. You could also use a hardware device like a YubiKey. This is why all the big names are supporting passkeys. Instead of focusing on something you have to remember, passkeys use something you already have, your phone, tablet, or laptop. So how do passkeys work? Let's get a bit technical for a second and talk about public key cryptography. Imagine Alice wants to securely receive a message from Bob. Alice generates two keys, a public key and a private key. Think of them like a padlock and a key that are connected, like siblings, but unlike siblings, they actually get along. Alice can share the public key with Bob or anywhere else for that matter, even with a hacker. The public key, as the name implies, it's public, it's not a secret. Bob can use the public key to lock or encrypt a message and send it back. Only Alice can unlock or decrypt the message using her private key, which she keeps safe and never sends over the internet. This encryption is so strong that breaking a modern key would take, around 300 trillion years, give or take. Now, in most real-world applications, public key cryptography is typically used for signing and verifying. And passkeys work on the same principle. Here is how it looks in practice. When you register for an account with a website, your device creates a public-private key pair. The public key goes to the website and gets stored in their database. The private key stays hidden on your device. During login, the website sends a challenge, basically a random value, to your device. Your device signs this challenge with the private key and sends it back. The website checks it then against the public key. If it matches, you're logged in. No password involved. This method is also called passwordless authentication. Since passkeys don't rely on something you know, like a password, but on something you have, your device, it's harder for hackers to break in. Now, the weak link isn't the passkey itself. It is where the passkey is stored. This also makes sharing your Netflix password a bit tricky since there's no password to share. But anyway, we'll figure something out. So what does a passkey look like in practice? Well, we don't really see it. It's all behind the scenes, and this is kind of the point. Passkeys are stored in your browser or by services like Apple iCloud Keychain, Google Password Manager, or 1Password, just to give an example. And all these systems can also sync passkeys across devices. But if you're really curious how these keys look like, here you go. If you want to see passkeys in action, check out webauthn.io. Webauthn, a protocol that powers this, lets you securely register and log in without passwords. So let's give it a try. I'm gonna use here a username. Click on register. And this is when my browser is going to prompt me to put my fingerprint. And this passkey has been saved. As you can see, I don't need to remember anything, but now I can see this passkey in the Google Password Manager. And again, to unlock this, I have to provide my fingerprint. And as you will see here, there's only my username that's being stored and associated with this. Even if I click on edit, there's not really anything to see here, so the actual information that has been stored is not being revealed. So let's go back to the website. Now we have registered with the service. So let's click on authenticate and see what is happening. So we already have inputted the username, and now my Google Password Manager is asking for my fingerprint. I'm gonna provide it here. And now I'm logged in. These are, of course, some technical details here. I can also go ahead and delete my account. But it just goes to show that if implemented properly, it can be a very nice user experience. In a similar way, it works if you use a mobile device, and generally you'll be asked to authenticate with your fingerprint, your face ID, a PIN. But the idea is there is no password needed. You cannot forget your face or you cannot forget your fingerprint. Right now, we are in a transition phase. Most accounts still use passwords, but you can also log in with passkeys. Also, MFA is not dead. Some services may still require MFA in addition to a passkey. And of course, this is super confusing to everyone. The future, new accounts may not need passwords at all. But in the meantime, try out passkeys. And if the service you wish to use doesn't support them, at least set up MFA. So what do you think about passkeys? Are you using them already? Leave a comment below. If you like this explanation, give this video a thumbs up and write a comment for the algorithm. This way I know to create more videos like this one. Thank you so much for your support and see you next time.